No, I'm really smiling because we had a good day of practice. You know, very intense. You know, anytime 24 practices, it's going to be an intense practice. And I think he brings out the best in the guys. And it's a good way to start the trip. You know, we know it's going to be a tough trip. You know, anytime you open with San Antonio, it's going to be tough. But again, just going by our last game and the way we played on the defensive end, you know, very happy about that and excited. And we'll see where we are.
And especially with him playing more at the point guard position.
Well, again, that was at the end of the game, and it was just something that I thought would work. And obviously it worked pretty well, and it's something that you guys will probably see in the second half of games, probably for the rest of the season. I don't know how much, but, you know, I love him when he has the ball, because obviously when he's playing, there's, you know, five other guys on the opposite team that's paying a lot of attention to him. So basically all our guys got to do is make shots, because they're going to get open shots.
Kobe seemed pretty fired up right now. What do you think irritated him from practice?
I don't think anything irritated him. I think he just did a great job of getting everybody else fired up. He's always fired up. You know, that's the great thing about him. He's such a competitor, you know. And when he came out here, like I said, you know, when he comes out and he practices, the intensity level in practice goes sky high. You know, and he challenges guys. This is what you should do, you know. And so today they responded by getting their butt kicked, but they wanted to play again. But I told them we got three games in 4 nights, so we have to do it another time. No, the starters kicked their butt. So I guess Nick's comment the other day that the starters had to catch up, caught up to him.
How big is it for Kobe to pass Michael Jordan in the all-time scoring list to you?
I think it's huge. You know, if you look at the you know, the top 10 scorers in that, you know, in this history of this game, you know, obviously we end up with number 1 and 3 just from this organization. So it's an unbelievable feat, and again, it shows his longevity and his greatness for so many years.
When you think of Kobe and MJ, what are their similarities, and then what are their differences?
Well, I don't know many differences, but I mean, their similarities are that both of those guys are vicious on the basketball court. You know, they're both just so competitive. They don't like losing, and they take that losing to heart. You know, and they're tough. They're tough. You know, they demand their teammates to play as hard as they play. You know, and I know that's the very similar, you know, similarities with those two guys for sure.
One-on-one in the heyday, who wins?
Oh, man, I don't know. Both of them, you know, both of them got the patented fadeaway. Both of them could jump out the gym. That would be a hell of a game to watch.
When I work for you, never let me guess how to guard somebody. Pick one. Who wins?
I have no idea. since I'm sitting here and I got Kobe with number 24 with the organization, I'm going to go with number 24 right now.